I know that our school on the eastern part of Slovakia took very like a leading role, and so am I. I was just so involved in that revolution, and I didn't see my parents back then probably for almost 2 months. I didn't go those 11 kilometers because we were so busy. We started to do or releasing our newspaper as a probably only one later on in Košice, something that's called Premeni. So our first job was go on the street and giving, I was actually also writing some, you know, some articles over there. And then we were giving these newspapers to people. And the time is just indescribable. Joy of people, we were giving a free food. I'm almost gonna have a tears in my eyes because that time is indescribable. People are in still, you say it's a communist era, and you go to store and you ask for, I don't know, some soup or some, and just don't pay, guys. We had tricolors, and so we were all kind of known from colleges. Nobody else did it, but we got like strike comedy and all that crap, you know. So they knew us. Taxi drivers gave us rides free, even to like Svidnik or anywhere. It's just, guys, don't even think about it. So we got taxi drivers waiting for us, and we were going from factories to factories, and our role was, those first days, we knew one thing: economy cannot collapse. And what happened in those factories, on every levels, people started to kind of fight personal crap on the leaders, on the Communist Party, and our role was actually to keep economy and factories going, because they were like, oh, we're not working, and we had to go there, and we were just telling, and which is great, they respect us. I don't know why. We were not the police, we were not authority, but we came and we actually had the director of a factory and ordinary workers sitting, and we had them kind of communicate. And so that's what was my role. You know.